Hi, I'm Torben Janssen from thoughtsonjava.org with a new Hibernate tip. Today I will answer a question about Hibernate 5's support for zoned daytime classes. But before we dive deeper, please subscribe and hit the bell icon to get notified about new Hibernate tip videos every week. During one of my recent Hibernate workshops, I got a few questions about Hibernate's handling of zoned daytime objects. To sum them up, all attendees wanted to know what's the best way to persist an attribute of type ZonedDateTime with Hibernate. Since version 5, Hibernate supports some classes of the Date and Time API as basic types. The ZonedDateTime class is one of them. But it's not supported in the way you might expect. Hibernate doesn't persist any time zone information for it. It converts the value to the local time zone and stores it as a timestamp. My current time zone is UTC+2. So if I persist the zone daytime in EST, which is UTC-4, Hibernate converts it to UTC+2 before it writes it to the database. This causes problems in a few situations. When you use a time zone with daylight saving time, or your systems use different time zones, or you change the time zone of your application for some reason. But don't worry, there is an easy way to avoid these problems. When you work with zoned daytime objects, you should use the configuration parameter hibernate.jdbc.timezone. Hibernate introduced it in version 5.2. It enables you to specify the time zone that Hibernate shall use for its conversions. In this example, I set the time zone to UTC, which is a time zone without daylight saving time. If you now persist a new entity, Hibernate tells you in the log messages that it persists the timestamp with the time zone specified by the local date. In this example, that's UTC-4. But when you take a look at the database record, you can see that it converted it to UTC. So all timestamps will now be converted into the configured time zone and not into the time zone of your application. Okay. That's it for today. If you want to learn more about Hibernate, you should join the free Thoughts on Java library. It gives you free access to a lot of member-only content, like an ebook about the Java 8 support in Hibernate, a printable PDF version of this Hibernate tip, lots of cheat sheets, and a video course. I'll add the link to it to the video description below. See you next week for a new Hibernate tip, and if you like today's video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe below. Bye!